We're here at Trump International Golf Links in Aberdeen on allegedly a fine Scottish summer's day, and I can say that because we're based here. But we're here for the launch of the Cleveland RTX-3 Wedge, and this replaces the 588 RTX-2. They've actually dropped the 588 name, which is a little bit of a surprise because it's been around since 1988 and they sold 10 million wedges with this on, but it does simplify the branding a little. The loft range is still the same. It goes from 46 degrees up to 64, and really what they've done with the new version is change the way that the hosel is in order to move the center of gravity a little bit closer towards the middle of the club. Now, why that is important is because if it's closer to the center club and you get more center strikes, you have more distance control, you'll be a little more accurate, and you'll get a better feel. Now, how they've done that is by making the hosel a little bit shorter here. They've taken a centimeter off the hosel, and that saves 9 grams. Now, 7 of those comes from that shorter hosel. The other 2 grams comes from actually creating what they call a micro cavity. So in the bottom of the hosel here, they've taken a little bit of extra metal out. Now, what that allows them to do is to make the center of gravity 4 millimeters further away from the heel than it was in the previous model. So let's see if this works. Now, the first thing you notice when you put the RTX-3 down is it's got kind of generous size head. It seems a little bit deeper on the narrow side of it. It's quite a sort of rounded shape, and certainly some of the head lofts in the different sizes almost look kind of square, but I kind of like this more mid-sized head, so let's see how it goes. Like all we Cleveland wedges, it does feel maybe slightly lighter than average, but again, I quite like that, and the feel is very good indeed, because it does feel a lot better than the RTX-2, which is what I was comparing it against earlier on TrackMan. Now, they made a few other changes as well. There's a different grind on the sole. In fact, there's 3 grinds. There's a low grind, a mid, and a full grind. And basically, they've got more sort of sharper V-shaped sole, which is there to help the club get into the turf and out a lot quicker. And certainly, they say, Cleveland say, compared to the RTX-2, it's about, there's 20% less loss of club head speed as you go through the turf with this new sole. And certainly, I found even from these really tight lies here on this links turf, that is really going through the ground very easily indeed. The key thing really is obviously to get the right level of bounce for your own game. I'd probably urge you to go with as much bounce as you can take, because really bounce is your friend. It's there to help give you a little bit more margin for error. So even for me, I've gone for the 3-dot grind, which is the full grind, but the 2 and the 1 symbols, which you've had before, are still there as well. They've also changed the grooves on the face. It's now called the Rotex 3. And they've actually manufactured them in a slightly different way. So once they've cut the grooves, they then fill the grooves with plastic, and then they mill the face, and then they get rid of the plastic from inside the grooves. And that, Cleveland say, means they can keep the grooves as they're made, as sharp as possible, and also means that they can go right up to the legal limits. And certainly the spin from full shots and on and around the greens has been very impressive as well. Now, I had this on TrackMan against the previous RTX-2, and what was very noticeable was that the ball was flying a little bit lower. Certainly the launch angle was a lot lower, and the spin was quite a great bit deal higher. Now, obviously it depends on what loft you use, but certainly that was what Cleveland expected to happen with this different CG position. Now, on full shots, I think this is a really lovely wedge to hit. It's very well balanced indeed. And, you know, when you're building a set of wedges, you're going to need a few that do for full shots. I've also taken them around the green. The feel around the green was excellent. I mean, what you want is that versatility. You're able to hit it in nice and low if you want to, and it'll run out or give a little bit of grab if you get it correctly. But even with the fullest grind, which is what I have here, you're able to sort of open the face and just slip it underneath the ball, just give it that slightly higher fight to help it stop a little bit quicker. So the versatility of this is excellent. Now, wedges have to work out of this stuff too. They're probably going to spend a bit of their life in here, but the bounce on the RTX-3 really works very well. You can really feel it engage with the sand, allowing you just to flip the ball out. And the feel is just really good. I'm really getting a good amount of spin off the face here. And even with a 56 that I've got here, you can really open up the face and flip it under. So overall, I think Cleveland have done a great job with the RTX-3. I think it looks very clean indeed. I do like the new look. I think the choices in bounce and grind are excellent. As I say, I probably would towards the sort of higher bounces as they do go through the turf region. It certainly feels very balanced through some of the fuller shots. As always with Cleveland wedges, they'll be pretty competitively priced, and there's a good choice not only of lofts but of finishes. There's the satin chrome, which is the one I have here. There's also a black finish, which Cleveland say is much more durable than they've had before, and it will look better for longer. And in time, there will also be a raw finish, which you'll see on tour, which was a more sort of golden finish and will rust a little bit more over time. Whichever one you go for, I think you're going to find this is a really high quality wedge. It's got a lot of options to be fitted correctly for you. The versatility is great. Performance on full shots is great, and around the greens, I think it's going to deliver all that touch and feel that the better players, and indeed any golfer of any handicap, should need. Please let me know what you think, leave some comments below, and for more reviews on all Cleveland equipment, just check out the Golfalot website.